why animals don't cross this invisible wall. Imagine a mysterious, invisible line that separates two worlds, one with animals found nowhere else on Earth, and the other with a completely different set of species. This line, known as the Wallace Line, is a natural boundary that runs between the islands of Bali and Lombok in Indonesia. But it's not just a geographic feature. It's a barrier that has shaped the distribution of life on Earth for millions of years. So, what is this invisible line, and why does it exist? In this video, we'll explore the science behind the Wallace Line, its historical background, why it happens, and how it divides the animal kingdom. The discovery of the Wallace Line. The Wallace Line is named after Alfred Russel Wallace, a British naturalist who, along with Charles Darwin, is credited with developing the theory of evolution by natural selection. Wallace spent years studying the biodiversity of Southeast Asia and its islands, and it was during his travels that he noticed something fascinating. As Wallace explored the islands of the Malay archipelago, he observed a dramatic difference in the types of animals found on either side of a specific line running through the region. On one side, he encountered animals that were similar to those of Asia, like tigers and rhinoceros. On the other side, he found species more commonly associated with Australia, such as marsupials like kangaroos and wallabies. Wallace's observations led him to propose that the region was divided by an invisible boundary that separated two distinct ecosystems. This boundary became known as the Wallace Line, and it marks one of the most important natural divisions in the world of animals. Where does the Wallace Line exist? The Wallace Line runs through the Malay Archipelago, which is a group of islands located between Southeast Asia and Australia. This line roughly divides the islands of Bali and Lombok, just east of Bali in Indonesia. However, it doesn't stop there. The Wallace Line continues, stretching from the Arafura Sea between Australia and New Guinea, through the islands of Sulawesi, Borneo, and the Philippines, and all the way to the north coast of Australia. What's fascinating is that this invisible line doesn't follow any obvious geographic or physical feature like a mountain range or a river. Instead, it is an ecological boundary, a line where two distinct faunas or animal communities meet. Now that we know where the Wallace Line is, let's dive into the science of why it exists. The key factor lies in geological history, specifically the shifting of Earth's tectonic plates and the rising and falling of sea levels over millions of years. The formation of the Wallace Line is closely tied to the movement of the Earth's tectonic plates. Tectonic plates are huge sections of the Earth's crust that float on the semi-fluid mantle beneath. These plates move over geological timescales, colliding, pulling apart, or sliding past each other. Around 50 million years ago, the land masses that would eventually become Southeast Asia and Australia were part of a much larger landmass, often referred to as Sunda Shelf. As the Earth's tectonic plates shifted, this landmass broke apart. The land masses that formed Southeast Asia, to the west of the Wallace Line, and Australia and New Guinea, to the east of the Wallace Line, slowly drifted apart. Between them, the Sundaland region was submerged, forming what we now call the Wallacea region, which is home to the islands that sit between the two regions. The important part here is that while the land masses themselves moved apart, the faunas of Southeast Asia and Australia were evolving separately. This geographical separation led to the development of distinct ecosystems, which became more evident as the two regions became isolated by the sea. Here's the interesting part. The Wallace Line exists because of sea level changes. The rise and fall of sea levels over millions of years due to climate change and ice ages played a pivotal role in creating the Wallace Line. During ice ages, the Earth's temperature dropped, causing sea levels to fall, exposing land bridges between islands and allowing species to migrate. Conversely, during warmer periods, the sea levels rose and submerged these land bridges, preventing further animal migration between regions. The Wallacea region, the area between Southeast Asia and Australia, has experienced many such shifts in sea levels. At times, when sea levels were lower, animals from both regions could have crossed over these exposed land bridges, mixing species from the two different faunas. However, during warmer periods when the sea levels rose, these bridges became submerged, effectively isolating the two ecosystems once more. One of the most critical periods in this process occurred around 18,000 years ago during the last ice age, when sea levels were much lower than they are today. At this time, land connections existed between the islands now separated by the Wallace Line, allowing animals to migrate between regions. But as the ice age ended, sea levels rose, and these land connections were lost, leaving behind isolated ecosystems that evolved separately. Another important factor contributing to the Wallace Line is the presence of deep ocean trenches and narrow water channels that separate the islands of Southeast Asia and Australia. One of the most significant features is the Makassar Strait, a deep ocean channel that runs between the islands of Borneo and Sulawesi. The strait is too deep for most land animals to cross, even during periods of lower sea levels. This depth helped maintain the isolation of the two faunas. What the Wallace Line divides. The Wallace Line is more than just a geological boundary. It divides two major zoogeographical regions. Sunda, on the west side of the Wallace Line, the fauna is more similar to that of Asia. This includes species like tigers, rhinoceroses, and orangutans, animals typically found in Southeast Asia. These species evolved in the tropical forests of the region. Sahul, on the east side of the Wallace Line, the fauna is more similar to that of Australia. Here, you'll find species like marsupials, kangaroos, wallabies, birds of paradise, and the giant cassowary. These animals evolved in the isolated environment of Australia and nearby New Guinea. The Wallace Line essentially marks the boundary between these two distinct animal groups, and the result is a remarkable contrast between the ecosystems on either side. One of the most striking examples of this difference is the presence of marsupials, such as kangaroos, koalas, and wombats, on the Australian side, and the absence of marsupials on the Southeast Asian side. Instead, the animals of Southeast Asia are placental mammals like tigers and rhinos. Why are there no marsupials in Asia? It's because the ancestors of these animals evolved on the isolated continent of Australia. And after the Wallace Line was formed, the animals were unable to cross. So why does this matter in the broader scope of evolutionary biology? Well, the Wallace Line gives us insight into the process of evolution and speciation, how animals evolve to become distinct species. It also provides a living example of how isolation can drive evolutionary divergence. For example, because the animals on the east and west sides of the Wallace Line evolved in isolation, their genetic makeup and physical traits are vastly different. The tigers of Southeast Asia and the kangaroos of Australia share a common ancestor if we trace their evolutionary roots far enough back in time. However, millions of years of separation have led to the development of two distinct species, adapted to the specific environments in which they live. Wallace's discovery helped Darwin and others develop the idea that species evolve through natural selection. The concept of geographic isolation, where populations of animals are physically separated by barriers like mountains, seas, or other natural features, became central to understanding how species diverge over time. In addition to providing an interesting window into evolutionary processes, the Wallace Line also plays a key role in the biodiversity of the region. The islands on either side of the Wallace Line are home to some of the world's most unique and fascinating species. For example, on the Sunda side, west of the Wallace Line, you can find the Sumatran orangutan, Indonesian tigers, and Asian elephants, species that thrive in tropical forests. On the Sahul side, east of the Wallace Line, you'll encounter kangaroos, wallabies, koalas, and the strange platypus, all species unique to Australia and nearby regions. This division has led to incredibly high levels of endemic species, species found nowhere else on Earth, on both sides of the Wallace Line. This makes the region one of the most biologically diverse areas in the world. The Wallace Line in today's world. While the Wallace Line itself is an invisible boundary, it has had real consequences for the plants and animals living on either side. The line itself is not a hard boundary, but rather an ecological boundary, influenced by geographical features, sea level changes, and the evolutionary processes that followed. Today, the Wallace Line still influences animal distribution in the region. Even as modern humans move across these islands, the historic separation between these ecosystems still shapes the types of wildlife that can be found. For example, you'll find a dramatic difference between the animals found on the Southeast Asian islands and the Australian islands, a result of millions of years of evolution driven by isolation. This division also has implications for conservation efforts. Many of the animals on both sides of the Wallace Line are endangered, often due to habitat loss, poaching, and the effects of climate change. Understanding the unique ecosystems on either side of the Wallace Line is crucial for protecting the biodiversity of the region. In conclusion, the Wallace Line is not just a geographical feature. It's a symbol of how the Earth's history has shaped the lives of its animals. This invisible line, which divides the animals of Southeast Asia from those of Australia, helps us understand the forces that drive evolution, speciation, and the development of distinct ecosystems. By studying the Wallace Line, we gain insight into how animals evolve when isolated from each other, and how Earth's history has left an indelible mark on the biodiversity we see today. The Wallace Line is a testament to the power of isolation, the impact of geography, and the wonder of evolution. So next time you read about the fascinating wildlife of Indonesia, Australia, or New Guinea, remember that there's an invisible line that divides them, and that line is the Wallace Line.